Thank you this morning. We give the praise, glory, and honor of God. The Lord, we are in our midst, and even as we look at your word, Lord, we pray that we pray for our human and for God. In the name of God. I refuse to speak my mind, but that Lord, your Lord, may speak to us, O God. Even through, O God, this mouth, O God, that we give this morning just to bring forth your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Okay. Okay.
Then shall thy life break forth.
Amen.
Amen.
Then shall thy life break forth as the morning, and thine health shall spring forth speedily, and thy righteousness shall go before thee. The glory of the Lord shall be thy reward. Amen.
Amen.
Now, we are saying this year that this is the year of my breaking forth. And I am unstoppable this year. Because last year there are things that caused us, that have stopped us to move in our lives. There are things that caused our marriages not to move as they are supposed to be. Amen.
Amen.
So many things that went down, like it was darkness all our lives last year. All the days of last year. It was like you are just in the dark. But the Bible says, or God is saying, thy light shall break forth as the morning. It means no matter how dark it is, morning will surely come. No matter how dark it will come, morning will still come your way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I'll talk about this same one, that my life will be for. My life will break forth. Our God today will give the example. Amen.
Amen.
Isaiah 55:10.
Isaiah 55:10.
Oh, we'll start from verse 8.
Isaiah 55:8. For many thoughts are not, for my thoughts are not your thoughts. Neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Verse 10. As the rain and the snow come down from heaven, and do not return to it, without watering the earth, and making it bound and flourish, so that it yields seed for the sower and bread for the eater. So is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Read verses 12 also.
You will go out in joy and be led forth in peace. The mountains and hills will burst into songs before you, and all the trees of the fields will clap their hands.
My God. My God.
Amen.
You see, each one of us has light in them.
Amen.
Amen. Now God is saying that your thoughts are not like my thoughts. Or your ways like my ways. But one thing that God has done to you and me is to put his light in us. Is to put his mind in us. Amen.
Amen.
Because what he means, his thoughts are not your thoughts, is when you are thinking in your human way. If you are using your flesh to think, if you are using your flesh to do things, then you are not doing them as he who would like to do them in your life.
What it means,
the same way God does them in heaven, that's how you ought to do it even on earth. Now God has put grass in the ground. God has put a seed in the ground. But that seed cannot come out. Except when the environment is good.
Amen.
Amen. Because your light can be the seed that God has placed in your life. Now that seed has to break forth. But without a very good environment, there is no way that seed can break forth. Now he gives us an example of the rain. If you are walking up there, you saw how dry the ground had been. Yet you were in punch by the pain.
Amen.
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 What do you mean,
Tanshi.
It is dry.
Niko yuma.
But what is there?
Amen.
It is dry. But the seed is there.
Niko yuma kama mbegu ilipo pansi.
But it can't break forth.
Ile singa chokelele.
Because the environment is not convenient or it's not convenient for what? For that seed.
Chukua mbamara kapena mbegu seed yo ene la panija mbegu.
So it requires the rain to come and wet the ground so that now the atmosphere can be okay in order for the seed to break forth.
Amen. Amen.
So God says, the rains when they come down, there is no way rain can go back without causing the seed to break forth. Amen.
Amen.
It means that the rain is something that makes an atmosphere or an environment for the seed to break forth. So God says, so is my word that I have spoken in your life. It shall not come to you. It shall not come to you without causing your life to break forth. Amen.
Amen.
Because it is only the word of God that will action or activate the seed or the light in you. Amen.
Amen.
It is the word of God that which will propel light to come out of you. But some of us, we have been in environments which are not conducive. Some of the government you've been are friends. They are friends who are bad people to us. David is trying to show us the kind of environment in the area of friends that we should be in. In Psalm 119 and verse 63. David says that I'm a friend to those who fear God. Therefore, they become a very bad environment for your seed to pay for.
For advice.
true. Amen.
Amen.
We were somewhere last night.
Then
this person said,
in a
Joseph, then this time that Tabanji, this time Kuba, something that is not Tabanji, and he died. Manji, that person is giving an example. Because the friend, he don't tell that Kuba, then I'm going to Abba. So I'm going to ask, Afrika Kuba, so that's the Tabanji. Is that a good friend?
No.
Don't choke up. It's me that's a good thing. Like a rich man, cheap winner. That's after now, because. Sakako winner. Amen. It's not long ago, yesterday. That's the danger of having wrong what?
Friends.
Instead of bringing peace in your life, they bring confusion.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
So God says, just like the rain come down, and it does not return, but it causes the seed to grow. So is my word. Another good environment that will attract the rains in your life.
And
when you develop a praying life, you need to be prayerful. The Bible says that you ought to pray at all times. You ought to pray at all times. Let's turn our Bible to Ephesians. Ephesians chapter 6 verse 18.
Ephesians chapter 6 verse 18. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions.
Pray in the Spirit on all
occasions.
Pray in the Spirit on all
occasions.
Yes, but it.
And pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints.
Pray in the Spirit on all occasions.
Teperani mumzimu, what it is chonsen?
All means what?
Sponsor, chonsen.
All means what?
Chonsen.
Nangu, nikupepele chate ngativangu javiri mamanyo.
Ah.
Nikupepele chate vangu javiri mamanyo.
Iya.
God is saying, even when things are difficult, you ought to pray. Because prayer is an act that activates your relationship with God. It is an act that strengthens your relationship with God. Because as you pray, even when things are difficult, God, you know this is a genuine Christian. This is a genuine child. He doesn't just want me when things are good. He doesn't just want me when things are bad. He wants me at all times. Amen.
Amen.
Prayer is an act that will what cause an environment to be better in order for your seed to break forth. When you fail in the class, what do you do? Do you condemn yourself? Get on your knees. Because it is only prayer that can bring out the sleeping giant in you. Amen.
Amen.
That is a giant that is sleeping in you. That is right in the inside of you.
But
that giant cannot stand and face the enemy if you are condemning yourself. So prayer will always cast out the spirit of condemnation.
Amen. Because
we know that prayer, God answers prayer. That's why he's telling us to say, pray in the spirit on all occasions. When he says in the spirit,
God
knows. Because in Romans 8:26, we do not know how to pray. Amen.
Amen.
We don't know how to pray. The Spirit prays within us. We
have
thoughts that cannot be expressed in words. According to the will of God. Amen.
Amen.
So the Spirit of God. You don't just need to pray anyhow. You need to pray in the Spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your light shall pay forth.
Your light
shall pay forth. The moment you take time to study, the moment you take time to pray. Let's see what Jesus Christ was doing. Mark 1. Are we there? Mark chapter 1. Verses 35.
Mark chapter 1, verse 35. The Bible reads, very early in the morning, while it was still dark,
yes,
Jesus got up, left the house, and went off to a solitary place where he prayed.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Very early in the morning. Jesus left the house.
Yes,
and he went in a solitary place. Where he could what? Pray. Jesus did not wait for the disciples.
Yes,
he desired that his light should break forth. But his light could not break forth. Except when he went into the presence of God alone. So it doesn't matter if your friend doesn't want to pray. You separate yourself. And be with your God. Because as you are praying, God is speaking to you.
You
are also quickening your listening part. God is also waiting on your eyes. You don't need anyone to help you. You require God himself. The moment you separate yourself, you get into a certain place. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because if you depend on me, I may not come.
If I stand up
to pray with you, but God is there with you. Jesus realized. In order for my life to break forth, in order for me to accomplish the mission that God has placed upon my life, I need to get back to him. I need to be refueled. To be refueled. Amen. That's what you need.
Amen.
Because Mafuta, as you are changed today, you are being refueled.
You are making bonches and I just mama foot.
Amen. You are being refueled.
Yes,
you may be able to face this week.
But you know, when I was in your sabbatai,
but even inside the course of the week,
or catch my sabbatai,
and be refueled again. So you need to be a praying vessel. Amen.
Amen.
And your life never be the same.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Prayer is very important. In order for my life to break forth, I need the word of God in me.
Amen. Amen.
I need the word of God in my life. The Bible in Romans 10:17. It says that faith comes by hearing. And hearing only by the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
Because I need the word of God. Now I cannot have faith if I don't take time to hear the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is nowhere my seed can break forth. If I don't listen to the word of God, for my seed to break forth, it requires faith. If you don't hear the word,
that's super amount.
Richard, do you know how your wife developed faith in you? It's because you gave her your word.
Amen.
That I love you, melody.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
The melody believed.
Amen.
And she began to move according to the word.
Yes.
Then before that, she was not your wife.
Uh-huh.
And she continued to move in that way. Then she decided to be your wife.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Amen.
Because that way develop faith.
Yeah, jamawe, napaka chukulupiniro.
And surely I can live with this man.
Yuna nina kainawa amuna.
So you need the word.
Kuni jamawe.
In order for faith to be strengthened.
Kuni chukulupia chama
chukulupia. In order for faith to grow.
Kuni chukulupia chama chukulupia.
There's no way you can break forth.
Kuni jamawe chama chukulupia.
If there's any word in you.
That's kuni jamawe umuliwe.
That is why.
Get to watch out.
In the same
Psalm 1:2,
the Bible says that his delight is in the law of the Lord. It he meditates day and night. The moment you meditate on the word, you become the word.
Huh?
Amen. When you meditate on the word, that when my friend proposed love to the wife, maybe she did not accept there and there. But the word remained with her. And that word is
now
the
foundation
of her life. So she began to think about the word.
Because
you don't meditate on the word. So that the gift in you may be activated.
The Lord spoke to Joshua. Joshua what is the
saying? Joshua 1 verse 8. Okay. He did three from verse 1 of the same chapter. Joshua. Joshua, son of Dan. Moses, my servant, is what? Huh? Are we there? What is Joshua 1 say?
Joshua chapter 1, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
After the death of Moses,
uh-huh,
the servant of the Lord,
uh-huh,
the Lord said to Joshua,
uh-huh,
son of Nun,
uh-huh,
Moses, my servant, is dead.
Uh-huh.
Now then you and all these people get ready to cross the Jordan River in the land I'm about to give to them, to the Israelites. I'll give you every place where you set your foot,
uh-huh,
as I promised Moses.
Uh-huh.
Your territory will be extended from the desert to Lebanon,
uh-huh,
and from the Great River, the Euphrates, all the Hittite country,
yes,
to the East Sea,
uh-huh,
to the West.
Uh-huh.
No one will be able to stand up against you,
uh-huh,
all the days of your life.
Uh-huh.
As I was with Moses,
yes,
so I'll be with you. I'll never leave you,
uh-huh,
nor forsake you.
Yes.
Be strong and courageous,
uh-huh,
because you lead these people to inherit the land I swear to their forefathers,
yes,
to give them.
Uh-huh.
Be strong and very courageous.
Uh-huh.
Be careful to obey all the law my servant gave you.
Do not be careful to what?
To obey
all the laws my servant did what? Yes, read.
Do not turn from it to the right or to the left,
uh-huh,
that you may be successful wherever you go.
Uh-huh.
Verse 8.
Yes.
Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. Meditate on it,
uh-huh,
day and night,
yes,
so that you may be careful,
uh-huh,
to do everything written in it.
Uh-huh.
Then you will be prosperous,
uh-huh,
and successful.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do not let this book of the law depart from your mouth. Amen.
Amen.
But you shall meditate on it.
It was the day is in Apple.
Day
and
what do you think about when you're sleeping? When you're walking, what are you thinking? Amen.
Amen.
Because what you say shows us what you think about. Amen.
Amen.
Whatever comes out of your mouth simply translates what you think. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God is saying, Joshua, son of God, my servant Moses is dead. But now you are going to lead these people to the land I promised them. That is the seed God has put in the life of Joshua.
And
he says, Joshua, now you have to be courageous. But you can't be courageous,
Joshua.
You need the law that my servant gave you. That is what you need. Now, this law, you should not turn from it, neither to the left nor to the right. But you should be careful to do everything written in it. You should not do some. Do everything written in it. But some people don't deceive you. You can't do anything that is written in the word. That's what they have taught you. But hear what God is saying. Do everything written where? In it. So, day and night, think about the word. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Okay, fine. Let me give you a very good example of Joseph.
Joseph
has a dream. Amen.
Amen.
When we read from Genesis, let's go to Genesis. We're not going to read though. When we read from Genesis, Genesis itself, the story of month, I mean total.
But it only has a
Amen. There's the story of Joseph. From Genesis 7, we begin it from verses 5. You are going to see here how God has given a dream to whom? Joseph. But Joseph was very much excited. Amen.
Amen.
Excitement, child of God.
Sometimes
kill your dream. Amen.
Amen.
Excitement will kill your dream. So Joseph had been given that light by God. In form of a dream. God told him that you are going to be a king. And you are going to be a leader. Your brothers and sisters will come and bow before you. Even your mother and father.
Amen.
Amen. When you have a dream.
That we not
you have to be careful as to who you share with. So Joseph, because he was excited, he had to share his dream with the brothers. Remember, he was number 11. He was the 11th son. So the brothers, what did they do? They were jealous.
Panam very jealous.
Amen. People will be jealous with the light that is in you. It does not just mean people from outside.
It means
people from within.
They'll
be jealous of the gift of God upon your life.
Amen.
Amen.
They'll
be jealous. And don't be thinking of a way to terminate that light in your life. So Joseph got the long story short.
Joseph
put in a beat.
Amen. Amen.
He was put in a beat. They are people who try to put you in a beat, child of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They'll take away your clothes. They'll take away your clothes.
But they cannot take away your dream.
But they cannot take away your dream.
So I think they cannot
take away your dream. They can take away your peace.
But I think they cannot
take away. They'll not take away your dream.
So I think they cannot take away.
This dream is in the inside of you.
So I cannot take away that in my
own. It is only you who can take from yourself the dream.
You are doing what just like my dream.
Even when Joseph was placed in the pit, the dream still remained with him. Amen.
Amen.
As if that is not enough. In the life of Joseph, they took him out of the pit. Amen. They took him out of the pit. And
they
sold him to the Midianites. Even when he was sold to the Midianites. The Lord was still with him. Because the dream in him represented God himself. The dream did not come from himself. It came from God. God showed him that this is what you are to become. So that was the talk of God in the life of Joseph. Amen. So in the pit, God was with Joseph. When he was sold to the Midianites, God was with Joseph. Now he was also taken to the marketplace.
anapega pamalenga pamalo kuisa malonda
in that marketplace
anakulisikamamaaolo
bakula
zovala
vamakimaliseche sozalemba
kutimada kapolo
panakukula
zovala
aliyezopita
zazotilikapolo
Amen. People will try to condemn you. People will try to bring you down. They will try to shame you, to bring shame on you.
But
I want to let you know, child of God, even then, the light cannot be taken off from you. Because it is God Himself.
Amen.
Amen. But God still has a way to bring forth your life. So even there, God was with Joseph. God forgave and bought
Joseph.
So Joseph is bought.
He
is blessed in Potiphar's house. The Bible says that the Lord was with Joseph. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord was with Joseph. When you read in Genesis 39 and verses 2, the Bible says, and the Lord was with Joseph, and he was a prosperous man, and he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian.
Amen.
He is a slave. But he was prosperous. Amen.
Amen.
In his master's house. Now listen to this.
Verses 3.
And his master was with him. Amen.
Amen.
And his master saw that the Lord was with him. Even when you are a maid somewhere, Joseph was a maid. But still, his life broke forth. And Potiphar saw the light.
Amen.
It means the way he spoke. It reflected God. The way he did things. It reflected God. Amen.
Amen.
So you are the main player. If the light should break forth. If your light is to break forth. You are the one who should have the right attitude to God Himself. In your life.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That was it now. Potiphar's wife liked Joseph. In order for your light to shine. In order for your light to break forth. You still Mrs. Potiphar in your life.
When you come now, my Potiphar, my wife.
Amen.
Amen.
Mrs. Potiphar has seen that you are a blessed child of God.
We will cast on Potiphar all the
blessings of God to support your life.
Who got the Bible to prepare you?
But she wants to kill it.
He has a vipa.
Potiphar's wife wanted to sleep with Joseph.
We Potiphar, because we are not going to go to Joseph.
And the Bible says that Joseph ran away.
When he ran away,
he was placed in prison.
The Lord
says even in the prison,
God
was with Joseph. Because the light could not be taken out from him. Since he ran away from Potiphar's wife, Potiphar's wife said, no, this man wanted to rape me.
We put him
on the
other side.
He Then the man was blessed in
church.
You have been crying. That my marriage has been on rocks.
It
caught the spirit of the wife of Potiphar. That does not want you to enjoy your life.
That
does not want you to enjoy your marriage. The spirit of Mrs. Potiphar,
will
want to kill your business. The spirit of Mrs. Potiphar,
will
want to kill in your dream. But you need to run away.
Amen.
Now in prison, the Lord was with Joseph. And the Lord took Joseph from the prison, the palace.
Joseph took
finally, Joseph becomes the governor. Number two from who? From Pharaoh. Because he used the gift in him.
Amen.
Amen. He interpreted the dream that this man, Pharaoh, had. So it doesn't matter how long you have been in prison. It doesn't matter how long your gift has been sat on. So that your gift may break forth. In Jesus' name. So your life shall break forth. Your
gift
shall break forth. Your gift shall break forth. Your marriage shall break forth. Your life will never be the same.
But
God will use any way that He wants. Don't complain.
You
are in the pit. Don't complain. When your friend insults you. Don't complain. When your shame is brought upon your life. Don't complain. When you are placed in prison. There is no joy. Because in
Isaiah 55,
the Bible is saying,
"The
mountains will clap for you. Joy will go before you.
The
trees will begin to clap for you. Because you have become your unstoppable. So even what seems to work against you,
they
begin to praise you.
They
begin to rejoice.
Because
of the light of God that shall break forth in your life." In the name of Jesus Christ,
you may
stand to our feet. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Your light shall break forth. Your light shall break forth. The Bible said the joy of the Lord shall go before you. The joy of the Lord shall go before you. And the mountains, they shall make a way for you. The mountains shall make a way for you. Before you fail to pass, you
will
pass this time. Because you are becoming unstoppable.
There is
no way your light will be stopped. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is no way your light shall be stopped. Because no one can stand in the way of God. No one can stop in the way of God.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor, you are unstoppable.
You are unstoppable.
You are unstoppable.
You are unstoppable.
Your life shall break forth.
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 Tell your neighbor, they don't believe you. Tell them now that my life shall break forth.
My life shall break forth.
Tell your neighbor, my life shall break forth.
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 I am unstoppable.
I am unstoppable.
I am unstoppable.
I am unstoppable.
In the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
So, child of God, your help shall speedily come.
The
righteousness of God shall go before you. And the glory of God shall be your reward.
In the name of
Jesus Christ.
The righteousness
of God went before Jordan.
enenda kusogola kwa hiyo setting.
And the glory of God
ulemelea Mungu
was the reward of Joseph.
Inaenda kumbia kwa hiyo
setting. He became a governor.
Anataka kukaa mkuu.
Even in a foreign land.
O mano ya ulendo.
I want you to pray.
Ama mtipendele.
I want, first of all, before you pray, identify the bad environment that you have been in.
Zindikinani malo yoipa mne china limo.
Then you tell God to bring you out of that place.
Timuze mnakuta chichose mo malo ya chao ipa.
To help you come out of that place.
Utakati zile uchichoke mo malo yoipa.
And tell God now.
Timuze mnungu.
That lead me.
Nisogele
leni. To a place you want me to be.
Kwa mnungu malo ya mpa mtini
kaya. May your spirit.
Lekani musimu anu.
Put me in a very good environment.
Nikini mamalo ya kuto.
So that my light may shine.
Kutinyale yanga iwane.
My light may break forth.
Kutinyale yanga itokele
kuto. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Muzina la Yesu Christ.
I want you to pray in that line.
Tipa tipepele mulaini ya mene.
In Jesus' name.
Muzina la Yesu.
Prayer. Help me. enemy.
That is the name.
In the name of Jesus.
Anything
that is causing instability in my life. Be cast out.
Be just settled.
In Jesus' name. Prayer.
Yes, Lord.
Shall be blessed of God. Whatever they touch shall prosper. In the name of Jesus Christ.
house of God. I thank you. I bless your name. That as victors, you are entering this week. As victors, you are entering this week. As victors, you are entering this week.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, Father, the Lord will meet you at the point of your need.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus, Father, you shall not lack this picture of God.
Oh, God.
You shall not lack this picture of
oh,
God.
God.
In the name of Jesus,
yes,
Father, the peace of God shall be upon you now. This week, the